Hi, I'm Erica Gamet with CreativePro, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use and create your own media placeholders in a Keynote presentation. When using a Keynote template, there are often image placeholders right on the page. They're not just pictures plopped on the page, but they're a special built-in element that makes it easy to replace with your own images. In this presentation, I have some slides that use masters with image placeholders. To put an image of mine in them, I just need to open up a folder with my images, and I can drag and drop those items in. Let's grab this one here, and I'm just going to drag it on top of this image that's here, and replaces it with my image. Now, how did I know that was possible? I'm going to undo that. But come down here and look at this. I see there's a little icon at the bottom, and I see that on all the pages that have these image placeholders. Now, what's the advantage of that? If I go back to this image and replace it with the image that I had here, if I then switch this slide's master to a new one, let's tell it we don't want it this one, we want it to be the one with three images. You notice my image is still here. Now there's two more, and these are image placeholders. The advantage of using those placeholders is not only the drag and drop feature, but as I change the masters, it will move to the proper slot in those slides. Now let's see why that works. I'm going to undo a little bit and get back to our original here. And I'm going to go onto this page, and I'm going to edit the master slide. I want to look at why this is working. If I click on one of these, and come down to the bottom, I notice that there's a checkbox that says Define as Media Placeholder. It also has a name, Media. If I click on each of these, I see the tag changes slightly, Media 1, Media 2. Let's get out of this master and go to another one, edit this master slide, and if I click on this item, I also see that this says Define as Media Placeholder, and it's also called Media. Because it has the same name, the image tagged Media will be replaced with the other image tagged Media. It's a good idea to rename those to something a little more descriptive. Let's cancel out of that, and let's create a new master that has media placeholders in it. From any page, I'm going to click Edit Master Slide, and then I'm going to scroll down, and I'm going to choose the blank master, and I'm going to right-click on that, and just say Duplicate. This is my blank copy, and we'll give it a name. I'll call it 3 Grid. I'm going to put 3 images in a grid in here. So let's put a few images on this slide. I'm going to do Command-Shift-V, to bring in some new images. And I'm going to go ahead and grab a couple here. I'm going to command click on these and click insert. And it brings them all in. I'm just going to quickly arrange these on the page. Okay, now let's make these into media placeholders so that I can drag and drop new pictures on them. Select an image, click define as media placeholder, and it automatically assigns the media tag. Do the same thing with these other three. And click Done. So now if I decide to change the master to our new 3 grid, there's our setup. And just like before, I can grab new images and drag and drop on top of the media placeholder. Now again, if I change this master to one that just has one photo, because this is media 1, that item will remain. Just keep in mind that if you do go to a master that has fewer images, you'll lose those other images. But that's what the undo key is for.